this video, I like to show you how an ALA Zero automaton processes an input string. If you wonder where those automaton comes from, you can watch the previous videos in which I construct the automaton. Now, here we have our parsing table. Here is our stack, and here I will write the states with a Q. So Q0 is the same as this one, and these are my states, but they are a bunch of numbers which mean different things. So to distinguish them from each other, I will write them with Q here. Then here we have our remaining input, and here I will write our actions. Now we are in Q0, and when I look here in the table, I can see that the only thing I can do at the moment is that I can do a shift action. I can shift an A from the remaining input. I'm going to do this now. So now I will use this action. That means I get a new entry. I will write it further to the left so I have enough space to write it all down. So from Q0, I can shift my A onto this stack, from this stack to this. So here I'm left with AB dollar. And after the A, the shift says I'm going into state 1. So here I write Q1 onto my stack, and the action was S1. Now on this line I'm in Q1, and well, the only action I can take here is those reduce step. And that's what I'm doing now. I'm doing a reduce with rule number 2, which is this one, and that means that I can replace the A which I have on the stack by the non-terminal A. So I'm sticking with the Q0. I will take away the A and everything that's after it, and I will get the non-terminal A for that. And now I have to look where I have to go, because here you see I'm in Q0 and I have a non-terminal A, and let's see where I am going to. In Q0 with the non-terminal A, I'm moving to state Q2. And the remaining input is the same. And the action was a reduce with rule number 2. Now in Q2, let's see what actions I have. I can shift from the stack. I can shift either A or B. In this case, I have an A on top of the stack. So now I'm using this rule. Here I am. Now I'm shifting the A from the stack, and I'm doing a shift into state Q1. And here I'm left with B and dollar, and my action was shift 1. In the next line, now I'm in state Q1, and the only thing I can do now is a reduce. So I'm now doing again the reduce. That means I'm using the same rule, of course. I'm taking this whole part away as I did before, and now I'm left with Q0, A, Q2, then I replace this part by my non-terminal A, and now from Q2 with the A, because here I'm in Q2 and I got an A on the stack, now in state 2 with an A I'm going into state Q2. And of course the input stays the same, and we did a reduce with rule number 2. Now in Q2, what we can do now is, the only thing we can do now is to shift the B. So I'm left with all of this. Then I shift my B. And it says, when I shift my B, I move to state 3. So I'm here now, I have Q3. And the remaining input, because I took the B away, is I'm left with a dollar. And the action was a shift into state 3. So let's have a look at what we can do now. Now we are in state Q3. In Q3, I can do a reduce step with rule number 4, which is B expands to the terminal B. That means now I can replace this part by my non-terminal B. The rest stays the same. Now I'm getting my non-terminal B. And I have to look which state I have to write down here. So in Q2 with a B, I get Q4. And the rest stays the same. Now in this state, in Q4, the only thing I can do now is a reduce step with rule number 1. So that is this one. That means I have to replace all that part. I have to replace all that part by my non-terminal S. That's what I'm doing now. So I'm left with what we had before. Here I have my S. And then I have to look in Q2 with the S. I'm going to Q5. So I'm writing down Q5 here. And the rest stays the rest as usual. Now in this state, now we are in Q5. The only thing I can do now is to reduce with rule number 3. So in rule number 3, which is this one, I replace the part with the non-terminal S. Then in state Q2, with the B I got, I'm moving to state number 4. That was a reduce with rule number 3. Then now I'm in state Q4. I can do again a reduce with rule number 1. So now I'm replacing all this part. So I got my S. Now from Q0 with the S, I'm going to state number Q6. And that was a reduce with rule number 1. And now in Q6, as you can see here, I don't have any more actions I can do. I just have here my accomplished. So now let's see if the automaton really accepted my input string. This is the case if we have the start symbol as the only symbol on our stack. And I need to be in an accepting state as we are here, because accepting is the only thing I can do in state Q6. And also my remaining input must be empty as it's now. There's only the dollar is the marks the end of the input string. So we don't have any symbols left. And because the three conditions are fulfilled, our automaton accepts the input string.